Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. On today's video, I'm going to be showing you how to take your favorite plain tea towel and turn it into something custom and unique for you. I hope you enjoy. Started. Okay, so the first thing you'll want to do is start off with a clean, dry tea towel. Just use your favorite tea towel. I even ironed mine to make it a little bit easier. My favorite way is to use a stencil like I did here, but I know not everybody has a stencil. So first I'm going to be showing you a few ways to do it without a stencil. One being that I did this tea towel here that kind of looks like a grain sack stripe. You could even do two thinner stripes alongside it, and I just painted it off with painter's tape and then used a paintbrush to paint my stripe on. Now I always use DIY clay-based chalk paints for my tea towels just because that's what I have on hand, but I would recommend a fabric paint that you can buy pretty much at any craft store or Walmart. The key with this is that I let my tea towel, after I paint it, set up for 24 to 48 hours and usually a little closer to 48 hours. And then I heat set it with an iron on whatever setting my fabric calls for. And then I go ahead and wash it. So I do get some fading, as you can see with these two, but I actually kind of like that look. But fabric paint will probably keep a brighter, bolder color for you for longer. When I do heat set my towels, I make sure to put a thin towel in between my iron and the freshly painted towel surface, and then go ahead and heat set it that way. I've also used stamps in the past. If you're going to use a stamp, I would recommend using a brayer to apply the paint to the stamp so that your edges are as clean as possible. But I also really like using stamps. But like I said, my favorite way is to use a stencil. So the first thing you'll want to do is make sure you protect your surface underneath your towel, and I'm just using a piece of plastic here. And then once you get started, if your tea towel has a loop at the top to hang it from like mine does, then make sure that is facing up at the top for you. I'm going to use two small foam brushes because I'm using two colors of paint, or you could use a small paintbrush. Try not to overload your foam brush with paint. I got some dripping with mine because I put too much paint on my foam brush. I didn't mind the look, but if you want to avoid this, then try not to overload it. For the next project, I'm using a sponge to essentially make my own stamp. You can print out a picture and trace it out onto the sponge, or you can freehand something. I'm just doing something simple, a heart, and then you can cut out your design and use that as your stamp. I did have a little bit of an issue getting my sponge to cut because it was a super thick sponge, but if you take it just a little bit at a time, it seems to work better than trying to do long strokes with your scissors. But this is a good, simple, cheap way to use a sponge that you might have at home to make your own stamp.
Thank you. Applying even pressure across the entire surface of your sponge helps to get the paint spread out more evenly. I filled in some of the white parts of my heart with a paintbrush, but if I would have pressed down better, I think I would have gotten better results. For my next two designs, I'm going to be using stencils. JRV stencils are my favorites. She has a lot of different designs, and I'll link the website down below. But hers are washable and reusable several times. But if you go to, I think, Lowe's or Home Depot, I can't remember which one, they have the Americana Decor stencils, which I also like quite a bit. They are also washable and reusable several times, and I'm showing you an example of that up here. For applying the paint to your stencil, you have a few options. I have a stencil brush, which is just a really stiff bristled brush because I do stencils quite frequently. But if you don't do stencils frequently, then you can buy these little sponge pouncers to apply the paint to your stencil. I've actually never used one of these before, but I am going to try it on this first stencil that I'm going to be doing. Stencils, it's really important not to overload your brush with paint, otherwise you'll get bleed through around the edges. I'm really bad at this because I get super impatient and just wanted to rush through it, and the second stencil on the top kind of ended up with a little bit of bleed through because of it. For the final towel, I'm going to be using my stencil brush, and I'm going to be doing a JRV stencil again on this one, the same as the one before, and I'm going to be doing a sheep design. You can see it actually takes a very little amount of paint to do tea towels. I actually have a lot left over, so it's always good to start out with less and then add more if you need it.
I hope you enjoyed this video and found a creative idea for yourself. If you liked it, please hit the like button. And if you're not already subscribed, please hit the subscribe button. I'd love to have you on my channel. Thanks for joining me today and have a great one.
Let me know in the comments down below which design was your favorite today. I actually think the one that I like the best in the end is the one I did first with the foam brush. Super simple, but I think the design is really pretty.